As of right now, 9 o'clock, police are still on the scene of a standoff in Pelham. Authorities say that 72-year-old George Labonte Sr. has been holed up inside a home on Jones Road since around 8 o'clock last night. Sherburne Road from Mammoth Road in Pelham to Drakett Road in Hudson is shut down. This is not Labonte's first standoff. Back in 2007, he held police at bay for nearly 5 hours after officials say he threatened a woman. The night before that incident, police had arrested Labonte for threatening a neighbor with a gun. We'll continue to update you on the story here on the web and also on the air. Everyone is okay this morning after an apartment fire in Keene. Fire officials say the flames broke out just before 1 o'clock this morning at 100 Pearl Street. 14 people lived in the building. Officials say that smoke detectors did go off and everyone made it out okay. There's no word on exactly what started the fire, but officials believe that it started in a second floor bedroom. The attorney general has released the paperwork petitioning to free Ward Byrd. He's the Moulton Borough man convicted of criminal threatening for waving a gun at a woman who trespassed on his property. In one of the petition letters, the Sandwich police chief wrote to the governor, "I know Ward Byrd, and I know what kind of man he is. And while professionally I cannot condone what he is convicted of, I feel that the sentence that was given is unjust given the facts and evidence in this case." The executive council could decide within a week whether to take up a hearing on Byrd's pardon request. Over the past 4 days, Dover police have had to deal with two robberies and one attempted robbery. Thursday afternoon, surveillance cameras at Care Pharmacy on Central Street captured the suspect as he walked in with a threatening note demanding painkillers. On Monday, an armed man wearing a clown mask demanded cash at the Shell convenience store on Silver Street. And Wednesday night, police say an 18-year-old Tyler Janvrin of Dover was arrested after trying to rob Smiley's Discount with a sawed-off shotgun. Police say at this point they have no reason to believe that the crimes are connected. The Broadway production of Spider-Man has been delayed for a third time. Yesterday, producers said that they need more time to fine-tune some things, including a new ending. The $65 million show has been plagued with setbacks and injuries, including this one. Chris Tierney, who was raised in Portsmouth, fell 30 feet during a run-through performance last month. He had surgery and is now recovering in New York City. Spider-Man Turn Off the Dark is now slated to open March 15th. And that's it for your morning webcast. We hope you can join us for more news today at noon.